Hello people, in this video let us look at this topic, contact lenses. So basically you know what contact lens are, right? They are artificial device, right? Where do you put them? Into the eye. So contact lens is an artificial device, okay? It substitutes the anterior surface of the cornea, okay? So where are you putting it? On the cornea. So you know what the cornea is, right? So cornea is this most anterior most part, right? This is cornea, and above it the only thing that will be there beyond it will be the tear film.
Tear film.
Yeah, tear film. Okay, so cornea and in front of it only tear film will be there. So cornea, so over that you will put the contact lens. So where are you putting the contact lens? So you are putting the contact lens over the cornea. So here you have the cornea. Over that you will put the contact lens. So what is there above the cornea? Tear film, right? And above that you will put the contact lens. So usually you can say contact lens, where will you put? Over the cornea. So why are you putting this? To give some refractive error correction, okay? So it is an artificial device whose front surface substitutes the anterior surface of cornea in addition to correction of refractive errors, okay? The irregularities of the front of cornea can also be corrected. Wow. So irregularities in the front of surface of cornea also can be corrected. But main thing you remember is refractive error can be corrected. Okay. So just remember this one. Artificial device. Okay. So people, in this video we want to look at what and all. Types of contact lens. We want to look at the parts of contact lens. We want to look at the indications of contact lens usage, contraindications of contact lens usage, principles of fitting and care of lenses. All this we want to look at. So what do you think these contact lenses are made up of? They are made up of silicone hydrogel. Okay, you can just remember this if you want. Silicone hydrogel. Now let us look at the types of contact lens. There are many types of contact lens available, right? Hard contact lens, rigid gas permeable, rigid gas permeable lens, and soft lens. Okay, the one we use normally, at least I use, a soft lens. Okay, so let us look at these. Nowadays guys, you have all these colored lenses and all. It's become really, really fancy nowadays. Okay, let us look at hard lens. So basically hard lens has this material called PMMA, polymethyl methacrylate. Okay, what is it? Hard lens, polymethyl methacrylate. Okay, so basically this is having high optical quality, stability. It's light in weight, though it is hard. Okay, it's non-toxic, durable, and cheap. So this is cheap, at least that much we can remember. Cheap, right? It is actually not used much, okay, because it is not permeable to oxygen. It's impermeable to oxygen, right? And there will be not much tolerance. It's hard, so itself can cause corneal abrasions, and it is hydrophobic in nature, so it resists wetting. So obviously there is no wetting also, so it will become very dry, right? So it is basically hydrophobic, and it can itself cause corneal abrasion, can cause corneal abrasions. Because it is itself hard, right? Okay. Yeah. So let's move on to the next type of contact lens, that is the rigid gas permeable lens. Okay. So rigid gas permeable lens, what do you think about these? So these rigid gas permeable lens, they are also, they are gas permeable. By the name itself, you can say they are gas permeable. Actually, these are called as semi-soft, but actually these are hard lens only, okay? And what else you should know? These are made up of silicone acrylate. Okay, remember this name if possible. Silicone acrylate, okay? And there is another one, cellulose acetate butyrate. If you want, you can remember this, but this is not used much, okay? So just remember silicone acrylate. This is hard. But it is called as semi-soft. Now let's move on to soft lenses. These are made up of HEMA. What is HEMA? Hydroxyethylmethacrylate. Okay. What is it? Hydroxyethylmethacrylate. This is very important, so pay attention here. Hydroxy ethyl methacrylate. Okay, these are made about 1 to 2 millimeter larger than corneal diameter. These are going to be more than the corneal diameter. That's what is you have to pay attention here. These are made about 1 to 2 millimeter larger than corneal diameter. What are the advantages? They have larger diameter than cornea. Okay, so basically let us look at the advantages. They are soft, they are oxygen permeable, they are most comfortable, well tolerated. So what do you think the problems, disadvantages will be? Basically these are very delicate. Okay, they have limited life, right? And they can some deposits can form over them, infections, they have more chances of infection, right? And the optical quality they give is inferior to the others. Okay, and it cannot correct astigmatism more than 2 diopters. This is important for astigmatism. Soft lens, the 2 astigmatism, high astigmatism, it will not be able to correct. Okay, so it has a problem of wettability also. That is why the soft lenses, what they give is mostly we can change them often, that kind of soft lens, so that you know they have a limited life and they are prone to infections. So soft lens, when they are given, they give like daily disposable soft lenses are available, monthly disposable, weekly disposable, bi-weekly disposable soft lenses. A lot of options are available. Okay, but these are so comfortable that people are ready to spend the money on them, right? Soft lenses. But you saw here, hard lenses are cheap. Soft lenses will be costly because of all these reasons, because you have to keep disposing them, right? And maintaining and caring for these lenses will be very, very important. Now let us look at the parts, curves, nomenclature of contact lenses. Okay, so basically you should know all these. Diameter of the contact lens, so you have so many diameters. You have overall diameter, then you have an optical zone diameter. It's pretty easy to understand, isn't it? So basically overall diameter is the greatest distance, right? Then what do you think the optical zone diameter is? Where the central optical zone of the lens is meant to focus the rays on the retina. Then you have curves of the lens. What curves you have? You have the base curve or the central posterior curve. Is it this one? Central posterior curve, which is on the back surface of the lens, right? To fit to the surface of the cornea. Then you have the peripheral curve. Here they have shown the peripheral curve. These are concentric to the base curve. So many terminologies here: IPC, PPC, intermediate posterior curve, peripheral posterior curve, etc. Let's not go to so many details. Then you have the central anterior curve or the front curve. It's the curve on the anterior surface of the optical zone of the lens. This curve determines the power of the contact lens, this one. So this will be the central anterior. The anterior one will determine the power of the lens. So that's what you have to remember: central anterior curve. Okay, central anterior curve. Then you have the peripheral anterior curve, is the slope on the periphery of anterior surface which goes up to the edge. Peripheral anterior curve. So this will be the peripheral anterior curve, isn't it? What do you think this is, the peripheral anterior curve, central anterior curve? Then here you have the intermediate anterior curve. It lies between the central anterior curve and the peripheral anterior curve. So in the parts, we looked at the diameter and the curves. Now let us look at the edge of the lens. Edge is already marked here, right? Lens edge. So it is polished and blended, right? So what else? Then coming to the power of the lens. These are some other terminology. So we said which one will determine the power of the lens? The central anterior curvature will determine the power of the lens. What is the power? It is measured in diopters, right? So power, if we are not wrong, is 1 by focal length, isn't it? Actually, the textbook says that the power of the lens, it is measured in terms of posterior vertex power in diopters. Okay, now let us look at the thickness of the lens. What do you think the thickness of the lens is? Center of the lens, you will check. Okay, the thickness of the lens. What is the tint? Tint will be the color of the lens. Interesting. So color, they all come to color also. Nowadays, you have all the fancy colors, right? It will be interesting to wear these. Except that we should tolerate them. Now, let us move on to the indications of contact lens use. Quickly, let us move to this. Why do you think people will wear contact lens? Because optically, they need some correction, right? Refractive error. Look at these. Like anisometropia. That is, one eye is having one type of problem. The other has a different type of problem. right? One can have myopia, the other can have hypermetropia. So basically, it can happen, this anisometropia can happen in unilateral aphakia, that is one eye doesn't have a crystalline lens. So basically, why can you use contact lens in this condition? Because binocular vision you can retain, right? You can maintain binocular vision in these conditions because the magnification, there is less magnification of the retinal image. Then in high myopia, these are all absolute indications of contact lens, okay? High myopia means what? Short-sightedness. So high, if it is high, high means what? Greater than 6 diopter. Keratoconus means what? The cornea is very thinned out and also is very conical, right? If it is a very conical type of a cornea, then they can use keratoconus. Irregular astigmatism, they cannot correct with spectacles. So they will give it with the contact lens. So basically what happens, if this is the cornea, right, this is the eye and this is the cornea, and there is lot of irregularity. See, they don't know exactly where to correct, right? So they will give a contact lens, which will be more, it will make the surface more smooth, right? And in between this irregularity and this contact lens, there will be tear film. So basically, the irregular surface now has become smooth. So in irregular astigmatism, they will use contact lens. Then, what are the advantages? The advantages are normal field of vision. See, with spectacles, you don't get normal field of vision. You have peripheral aberrations and prismatic distortions in spectacles. With contact lens, you will not have these kind of things, okay? And contact lenses don't get fogged. Like when you wear specs, right, and you breathe hot air, it gets fogged. But contact lens will not get fogged, right? And it is cosmetically more acceptable. So here they are giving only the advantages, okay? Then what are the other indications? We saw therapeutic indications are there. Let us look at these indications continued. Wait. So guys, let us look at the therapeutic indications. Basically, to correct, corneal diseases where there is non-healing corneal ulcer, bullous keratopathy, filamentous keratitis, recurrent corneal erosion is happening. All those things, to protect the cornea, they are giving the contact lens. Then if there is disease of iris, they are giving like aniridia, coloboma, albinism, to avoid glare. To avoid glare, they are giving contact lens. That's also very interesting. In glaucoma, they are giving it as a vehicle of drug delivery. Imagine, it's more like a carrier for medicine. Interesting, for glaucoma. Amblyopia, basically, for occlusion, because the child has to learn to use the lazy eye, they will occlude the good eye, isn't it? Then band-aid soft contact lenses are used following all these surgeries like keratoplasty and microcorneal perforation. So they are using contact lens as a bandage. Interesting, bandage soft contact lens. Let's move on to preventive indications, to prevent. So to prevent what will you give this? So to prevent simbliferon. Simbliferon means what? Like this, you can see the palpebral conjunctiva and the bulbar conjunctiva have got, adhesion is there. So you can say the eyelid is kind of sticking, right, to the eyeball actually, to the eyeball. So basically this is simbliferon. So what they will do, they will cut all these and then they'll give a contact lens so that whatever grows will grow over the, try to grow over the contact lens and not exactly over the cornea. Interesting, right? So that's a preventive thing. Okay, preventive we were in, right? What did we look at? We looked at simbliferon, etc. And also a restoration of fornices and chemical burn. So if there is chemical burn, they want to restore the fornices, to restore fornices, they are using exposure keratitis. So basically what happens if there is a lot of exposure and drying, right, this cornea can get ulcerated. So to reduce the exposure, they will give this person contact lens, right, to protect the cornea. All these are preventive. Then trichiasis, to make sure that the eyelashes don't stick, right, to prevent that trichiasis, they will give contact lens. So many preventive things are there. So nice. So that's trichiasis. Okay, so we are done with therapeutic, that is to help in some disease conditions. Preventive you saw in trichiasis, then to prevent exposure keratitis, then to in simbliferon, and also for restoration in chemical burns, right? That is preventive. Now coming to diagnostic indications. Now we'll move on to diagnostic indications. To diagnose something, is it? That looks interesting. So what can you diagnose? Diagnostic indications. During gonioscopy, electroretinography, examination of fundus in presence of irregular corneal astigmatism. Oh, if there's irregular corneal astigmatism, you give the contact lens and then examine the fundus, is it? Fundus photography, if you want to do. Goldman's three mirror examination. So many diagnostic indications are there. That's really interesting. Now let us move on to the operative indications. What are the operative indications? Let us see operative indications. What do you think operative indications means? Contact lenses are used during goniotomy operation for congenital glaucoma. These contact lenses are used during vitrectomy. All these contact lenses are used during operation. During endocular photocoagulation. Interesting. Okay, so what and all we looked at? We looked at optical, we looked at therapeutic, we looked at diagnostic, we looked at therapeutic, preventive, diagnostic, operative. Now let us move on to cosmetic. Cosmetic very easily people will see. What and all? If there is an unsightly scar and people want to cover it, they will use colored contact lens. If they have ptosis, right? So they will use haptic contact lens. What are haptic contact lens? So basically haptic means sense of touch. So they are saying in ptosis, that is where lid droop, right? So they have some special contact lenses which can help this condition, ptosis, okay? Then cosmetic scleral lens. There are scleral lens in thesis bulbi, they can use it. So basically this thesis bulbi means what? There is a non-functional eye, okay? It's a shrunken non-functional eye. Just for cosmetic purposes, they are giving it, okay? Thesis bulbi, okay? So, this is the scleral lens, it's much bigger. What's the last category here? Occupational indications. Why will you give in occupational indications like for sports people, for pilots, for actors? So, they give some occupational contact lenses, okay? So, these are the indications of contact lens. So, we looked at the optical indications, main thing you should know that, then therapeutic, preventive, diagnostic, operative, cosmetic, occupational. Now, let us move on to the contraindications. So, why do you think contact lens should not be prescribed? So, if there is mental incompetence, poor motivation, if the person has chronic dacryocystitis, that is the lacrimal sac, if lacrimal sac issues are there, right? So, you will not give these contact lenses. Then, chronic blepharitis. What is chronic blepharitis? Inflammation of the eyelids. Recurrent styes if people have. Styes is what? Stye. That's also called as a hordeolum, right? So, basically, a stye or a hordeolum if people have recurrent, should not give. Something to do with infection, pus. That stye, external hordeolum, basically affects the lash follicle, eyelash follicle. And then if people have chronic conjunctivitis, so what is conjunctiva? This transparent mucous membrane which covers here and it can be even behind the eyelid, okay? So that if that is inflamed, chronic conjunctivitis, if the person has dry eye, right? If the person has corneal dystrophies, right? If they have some problem related to cornea, corneal dystrophies if they have, and if they have corneal degeneration, if they have recurrent diseases like episcleritis, scleritis, iridocyclitis, episcleritis, scleritis, anything these people have recurrent, better not to give contact lens, okay. Last thing we want to cover here is the principles of fitting and care of contact lens. So basically, contact lens care is a very general topic. Use clean hands, store them in clean containers. You should not use old solution. You get lens solution, right? To wash these and care for these lens. Regular maintenance lens. You have to dispose them according to their disposable lens. You have to see how many days it has to be used and disposed, all that. If you have irritation, do not reuse the same lens, etc., etc. So many things are there about the care of lens. So, let's take a recap what we have seen in this video. This is more of a medical content. We are not looking at care, etc. that much. Contact lens So basically, what exactly are these artificial device which will adhere to the cornea and it will substitute the anterior surface of the cornea? So where do you use it? Correct refractive error and also to protect the cornea in some cases. So basically, there are three types of contact lenses. You have hard contact lens, rigid gas permeable lens, and soft lens. Soft lens, you should know HEMA or HEMA, you can say hydroxyethyl methacrylate. Okay, remember it is crying and it is late. So HEMA or HEMA is ethyl methacrylate and late hydroxyethyl methacrylate. It is going to be larger in diameter than the cornea. It has it is oxygen permeable. It is comfortable. It is tolerated, well tolerated because it is soft, and there are a lot of disadvantages because it is very delicate. It can get infected easily. It is disposable, so it will be costly. Anyways, moving on, we saw the parts of the contact lens. We saw the overall diameter, optical zone diameter. We saw the central anterior curvature. We saw the peripheral anterior curvature, and then we saw the intermediate curvature, something we saw. Then we saw the thickness. Then we saw the tint of it. Then we saw the edge of it, right? Then what did we see? We saw that the central anterior curvature determines the power of the lens. Indications for contact lens use, we saw optical indications, absolute, you should remember, are anisometropia, unilateral aphakia, high myopia, keratoconus, irregular astigmatism. And we saw the advantages of the contact lenses over the spectacles. Then indications, we saw therapeutic indications, basically to give it some healing from some conditions, like what? Some corneal diseases, some iris diseases, glaucoma for drug delivery, then amblyopia to as a occlusion, bandage soft contact lenses for keratoplasty, etc. Preventive, we saw that in terms of chemical burn to prevent simbliferon, for exposure keratitis to prevent exposure of the cornea and drying, etc. Then trichiasis to protect the eye, cornea from the eyelashes, right? Then diagnostic, we saw that we can even do it, use it for diagnosis, like in gonioscopy, electroretinography, that is ERG. Then fundus examination in irregular corneal astigmatism, fundus photography, Goldman's three mirror examination, and all that you can use a contact lens. In operation, in operations you can use, like in goniotomy operation, in vitrectomy, and in endocular photocoagulation. Cosmetic indications, we saw that if there is any unsightly corneal scar, you can use a colored contact lens. For ptosis, you can use a haptic contact lens. For thesis bulbi, cosmetic scleral lens. Occupational indications for actors, for pilots, for sportsmen. Then contraindications, we saw if the person has recurrent stye, conjunctivitis, any blepharitis, then recurrent diseases like scleritis, episcleritis, iridocyclitis, if they have some corneal dystrophies, if they have dry eyes, if they have chronic dacryocystitis, if they are not motivated, you should not force them, and if they are mentally incompetent to manage all this, you should not prescribe contact lenses. Principles of fitting and care of lens. So basically, you should know the power of the contact lens. It should be perfectly prescribed to you after all the examinations, and you should always handle them with clean hands, and you should clean them often, you should store them carefully, etc., etc., etc. That's all about contact lens. Basically, you should not use tap water, etc., for cleaning these lens. You get specific solutions to clean these lens. Okay, then what else? Along with these lenses, it's better not to use any other eye drops unless prescribed. And lens should be the first thing you do. Like what they say is, as soon as you wash your face and ready after the bath, you should wear the lens. And hair, makeup, everything goes after you wear the lens. And once you are done with the day, the first thing you remove is the contact lens. Then the makeup, then the hair, etc. So that's all about contact lens. We'll meet you in the next video. Bye bye. Just remember, this PMMA methyl crylate is common, okay? Methyl crylate. Here it is methyl methacrylate. Here it is ethyl methacrylate. This is polymethyl methacrylate. This is hydroxyethyl methacrylate. This PMMA, it is also a material in the intraocular lens. So when they want to replace the crystalline lens of a person, example in cataract, then this is the material again, okay? PMMA, polymethyl methacrylate. Remember, it's crying and it's late. So, PMME and HEME. These PMMA materials, they are non-toxic, they are cheap also, okay? Hard lenses, cheap, non-toxic.